Hello, and welcome to the Binkieboys podcast. Can you stop clicking over there? Thank you.
Who's clicking?
You were clicking, Austin. This is your host, Anthony. Our top comment from the last podcast was first by Austin with one like. This week on the Binkieboys podcast, I am joined by Austin.
Hello.
Patrick.
Hello.
And Griffin.
Hello.
Now, I don't know if you boys noticed or not, but
I don't think I noticed.
There's a little snow out there.
It seems to be.
No joke, when I started my car to leave McDonald's, it roared up real, real loud. You know.
I was there. Yeah, I remember.
As it
Patrick,
tends to do.
Patrick, how did you fare in this sleety weather?
Well, I almost slid into a car, but that's like usual for me. So, and there was a train, a ghost train, stopped me. So,
can you elaborate on ghost train?
I don't think he said ghost train.
No,
I'm pretty sure he said ghost train.
He definitely said ghost train.
I don't think he did. Anyways.
I said ghost train, but I will not elaborate.
All right.
Griffin, I believe you're up.
After I dropped you off in home, Austin, there's a car coming, and it looked pretty far away. So I backed out, but it wasn't far away, so it started flashing its lights at me, and then used the left lane to go around me.
That is quite unfortunate.
It was a little unfortunate.
Wait, they used the left lane to go...
Like, they crossed the double yellow lines to go around me.
But, and if I'm not mistaken, doesn't Patrick or Austin live on the left side of the street?
He lives on the... Okay, whatever side you look at, it's the left side.
Oh, fuck.
Well, on the right side is the medians.
Right.
What? No, you're lying.
Whatever. Anyway. It's so bad, bro.
It is. It's
like,
getting worse.
It's getting really
muy
bad.
Muy mal, as the Espanoles say.
Excuse me?
I feel like there's no greater fear than when your, like, ABS kicks in and you just start panicking.
I tried to turn into a street, and I was like, oh, shoot, my turn's here. So I put on my blinker and went on the brakes, and it just kept the ABS turned on, and I just went right past. I did not get a chance to turn.
I have definitely done that before.
And also on the way home, I tried to drift a couple times.
Did it work?
No, I didn't have much of a buildup. There was this open parking lot, but I was paranoid of a police officer being around and watching me, so I didn't really try it that much.
I saw a fucking police officer roll through a stop sign, too, on the way home.
Speaking of rolling through stop signs, have you guys noticed that everybody's going the wrong way down one-way streets in town? Like, it just started recently.
It's pretty bad.
I've seen semis do it. I saw somebody almost hit me today. Semis went right past the street that my church is on, down the wrong way. Probably could have killed the priest, bro. Just saying. Terrible.
Hey, some priest deserved dying, you know what I mean?
Jesus Christ.
I'm going to have to agree.
Let's all gang up and kill a priest, guys.
Yeah. Let's kill a priest.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking, yeah.
So anyways, the Golden Globes. Patrick, I know you had some strong feelings about them.
Yeah, I just felt that the Irishman, nobody fucking cares. Let's not talk about
the
this
Irishman.
This is the worst topic ever. Nobody, you guys don't know shit about movies. You guys don't know about movies.
Okay, so you're gonna have to talk about it.
Fine. So basically, Martin Scorsese came out with The Irishman a couple of months ago. It's pretty good. It's like 3 hours long. Everyone makes fun of it, but I think it deserves it, and it is really good.
What makes it a good movie?
There's a lot.
Explain.
It's a true story. Well, it's based on a book, How I Heard You Paint Houses, right? And
huh?
That's the name of the book?
Yeah, it's because that's what their slang for I heard you kill people. Because because the brain splattered the inside of the house.
Okay.
I understand.
I think I get it.
So anyway, it's just got really good cinematography, writing, the dialogue is really good. And it should have won, in my opinion. It got nominated for 5 different things. Didn't win one, so.
Didn't win any. Quite unfortunate.
Kinda got fucked, I'm not gonna lie.
It's honestly the Leo movie.
I've been
bro.
There.
You've been where? Specifically.
I choose to not elaborate.
I feel like maybe perhaps I'm going to pressure you to elaborate.
F1?
Patrick? For those of you non-gamers, F1 is to vote yes.
For those of you non-gamers, turn off the podcast right now. Get the fuck out.
Fair enough.
There goes all our views.
All 6 of them, bro.
All
in fact,
6 views.
If you're watching this on your phone right now, I want you to pull over by the side of the road and throw your phone into the river.
And while you're at it, throw up.
And then throw up so hard.
No.
Speaking of throwing up so hard, yeah. You shit your pants, Anthony. Talk about how sick you were.
Yeah. So Monday, I get home, and I'm like, man, I don't feel so good. And I think I'm just gonna chill out for a while and maybe lay down. I got that. It turned out I had that like norovirus thing that's been going around, you know. And then you got it like a day later. Anyways,
yes.
Moral
yeah,
of the story is
essential oils.
Around like 4 o'clock, I'm like, okay, I'm okay.
I'm right.
6 o'clock, I'm throwing up so hard that I shit my pants. And
we've all been there, man.
That's kind of the story.
And then after that, you went back to your room, and let me guess, there are lights on your bed.
Oh, somebody should explain that while I take this phone call.
Oh, Patrick, or no, Griffin. I think
I've heard the story about once or twice.
Patrick,
but, yeah.
Here to explain the joke. So Eric went to Austria. Eric, our friend.
The other Binky boy who's not here.
Debatable whether he's a Binky boy, to be honest. But
yeah, you're right.
Anyway, he went to Austria, and he said that when he got back, his mom had put lights on his bed after he talked about it to her. And he was so shocked that he told the story about 6 or 7 times to
all of us. Oh, no, it's definitely been more than 6 or 7. I'd go as far as to say 12 times.
It was somewhere in the realm of nobody gives a fuck about Eric. So that's basically the moral of the story.
Basically the moral of the story, please do not repeat stories.
Yeah, like, shut that shit off.
Shut that shit off. Before I take you out of the car.
I really like the professionalism from Anthony's Anthony friend. I'm trying not to say last names.
Arnold friend. Yeah, Arnold friend.
Takes a phone call in the middle of a podcast.
I think it's important for our viewers to know why we post so unfrequently. So, I guess I'll go ahead and say, basically, it's our senior year of high school, and we're all getting ready for college. You guys want to talk about where you're planning on going?
Sure. I want to go to
don't think anyone would care, but go ahead.
You know what? Well, since you don't think anyone would care, I don't think I'll share.
Yeah, me neither.
How about
that's
that?
That's fair.
How about that?
Don't share, that's fine.
I'm saying this not because I'm not going to college. It's because I don't.
Yeah, I'm definitely smart enough to go.
I got a 10 out of 10 on the ACT. So fuck you.
I took the SAT. I got a 36. So
I thought the SAT
score.
Was out of 100.
The SAT? You took the SAT and it was out of 36.
The SAT is out of 36, idiot.
Did you get a 36?
Yes, I got a 36. That's a perfect score.
Shit, bro.
I can't even read, so I guess you got a leg up on me.
You know, you know what upsets me?
What upsets you?
I was just sitting here, and I have YouTube open to like, just you know, and and one of my suggestions is a Mr. Beast video.
Yeah.
It pisses me off that Mr. Beast didn't win Creator of the Year, and that that Tana Mongoloid.
Who's heard of Tana Mongoloid? I don't want to offend any of our six nobody. Viewers, but I have never heard of her. So
I've not either. Isn't she? She's the one who like dated Jake Paul, right?
And that's who's Jake Paul?
Are you telling me there's someone out there with a first name Tan?
Are you telling me there's someone out there with two first names, Jake Paul?
It's actually it's Tanner, but you know.
You.
Cool. I thought it was like
Hannah.
It is. Yeah, but
Tanner. So you're telling me you can't have the name Tanner?
Yes.
Care to explain?
What do you mean care to explain?
I am extremely sexist. Hi, there, Austin there here. Misogynist and a racist. Nah, that's Patrick. I'm just kidding.
Anthony here. Sexist. Racist.
Hi, Griffin here to explain the joke. Anti-Semite. Joke here being...
The joke is, there is no joke. I literally hate all those groups. I have so much hate.
I can't explain that joke. It's too...
It's too edgy?
Hey, this guy in the game called me Bikini Boy instead of Binky Boy.
People always mess up the Binky. Like,
really?
They call me Blinky.
People like, in CSGO cannot read.
Like, where does the L come from? I don't understand.
Bikini Boy. He won't stop saying it. Por favor, do not call me Bikini Boy. Oh, he
stole
my
guns.
I'm
so glad there aren't, like, clan tags in Dota. Because everybody in Dota, like, they you know, you have to refer to each other because you have to communicate. But
yes,
nobody in Dota can read. And it's like everybody's, their names, like, I get called Mamba. Or
top 10 Moomba. Gamer problems. No one else in the game can read.
No one else. For real. And then I'll be playing and we'll be attempting to communicate. And then all of a sudden, somebody will say something, like, mildly snarky, and then some other guy will, like, go at him. And then it's kind of like this, like...
unending cycle.
It's kind of like a podcast, actually. You get to sit and watch other people talk, and they scream at each other. And
yeah,
then
I've been there.
It's like, hey, guys, maybe you could just calm down. And then there's some other guy who, like, speaks Chinese, and he's playing on American servers. And he doesn't know what's going on, because he doesn't speak English. But every once in a while, he's like... push me down. And I'm like,
I agree with this guy.
Nice play there, white Mamba.
It's true. Usually it's, okay. They say nice law, because, I don't know, I think nice law might actually be, like, nice.
Nice.
Right. Nice law. That sounds made up to me.
Yeah.
Really? You think it's based off of English?
If a language has that word, it is invalid, in my opinion.
Yeah. Are you saying the entire Chinese language?
I'm saying...
is invalid?
Yes.
I am saying that, like, 1/4 of the population that speaks Mandarin Chinese are invalid, in my opinion.
Why
in
1/4? Where did that come from?
It's been a long time coming.
What does that mean?
I wouldn't worry about it for now.
I have a long time racism streak in my family.
Broke my 90-year... oh, fuck. Broke my 18-year no racism streak. Nah, bro. It's been like...
I hate when that happens.
3 hours since I was racist.
That's pretty good.
That's not true. I did say like 2 minutes ago that I hate a lot of people.
That's true.
Pretty much all the groups that exist.
It's been about 3 minutes.
Yeah.
One thing that I think unites the whole school, like, Hicks and whatever, Goths and, like, everybody. We saw a group of furries walking out of school. No. Like, it was one person was fully furried up.
Furried up, like, at school?
Yes.
For real?
Yeah, it was me and Griffin, and we...
don't use names.
Everyone who saw it, like, universally, like, hated that person. Like, and it went across borders, like, damn.
I think, despite all the conflict in the world, right now with Iran and stuff, we can all agree on one thing.
Mm-hmm.
Furries are disgusting.
Yeah, bro. It's you know what? If we lose some furry viewers because of this content,
it is absolutely okay. I'm fine.
I think I'll be okay.
I'm not. We need to pander to them. I want views.
We need to the furry audience.
You guys want me to pander to the furry audience real quick, guys?
Yeah, please.
Let me just slip on my mer suit.
My mer suit.
I'm okay. A bit of a what do they call it? A gray muzzle.
I'm a bit of a gray muzzle myself.
For you normies out there, that's an old furry. You know what we should talk about? Did we talk about are the furries invading our Discord on the first podcast?
I don't think we did.
Yeah, the Discord we're in currently to record this is not our original friend group. Oh no, this one is.
It is.
We banned them.
We have like four Discords because we tried to avoid the furries for a while.
A long time.
Yeah. So what happened was, we were playing CS:GO.
It's painful to talk about.
And the other team, there's a clan on the other team because, you know, we're a clan, they're a clan, and the other clan is like, what was the name? Is like something for furries. It was very obviously furries. And you know,
I
so
think
naturally,
it was Yif Gang.
Yif Gang. Yeah, that's it. That's it.
Yeah, it was Yif Gang.
Now, and the terminology here is Yif is
something furries do. Look
it
up.
Something that adults do when they love each other very
but for furries.
Anyways, so the game progressed. I think we won the game.
We absolutely destroyed them.
Yeah, I think that might have been the outcome. But
and then Patrick.
This was actually the second time we had run into that squad in game.
That's true.
Was it Patrick who started flirting with them, or was
it
Griffin?
No,
no. You thought Sammy Boy was a girl?
Yeah,
I believe it was a...
Yeah.
Me and my wide-eyed innocence thought that they were just joking around, like.
Haha, furries. Yeah, they're ironically furries.
Nope.
And then Eric and I, the voices of reason, were trying to convince everyone that you don't play that. They're just joking game on the internet. But then they're like, no, it'll be fun. Let's invite them to our Discord. You know,
top 10 best
our private
time.
Discord.
Top 10 times I've had the best idea.
And then we did.
Oh, hello? My God. Socks for turtles.
That's right.
Turtle to be able to walk on water.
I did want my turtle to walk on water.
These socks can't fucking do it, but I'm sure the game.
I'm sure as hell gonna say they can.
Socks for turtles, baby.
This is advertising fraud at its finest, but you don't care.
Yeah, turtle socks.
For
only six orders.
Socks for turtles.
For only six payments of $19.95, you can get turtle socks for your turtle. These will fit box turtles, sea turtles,
painter turtles,
soft shell turtles, and anything in between. Oh, I hope you enjoyed that commercial break. Now, after we invited the furries to the old Discord,
Griffin started flirting with Sammy Boy. Yeah. He didn't talk much, so it was a mystery as to the gender. Keep in mind, this is Sammy Boy.
Keep in mind. And then when they did talk, it was a very deep-voiced, very obviously not a female. And,
basically it went like this. Griffin, pretend you're talking to me.
Well, Griffin is,
always talking to my mom.
Griffin, pretend I am Sammy Boy and you are talking to me.
Hey, Sammy Boy.
Griffin thinks I'm a girl. Hey. Mr. Infamous.
Well, she definitely. Here's how it went. He didn't talk at all.
No, they did talk a little bit at first.
Okay, the other one talked.
Yeah.
Sammy boy didn't really talk much, and he was just in the background. And the other guy would talk to him, and he's like, "Oh no, I don't think so." And that's about it.
Yeah. Long story short, eventually they started sending furry porn.
Which I don't will think now display on the screen now.
No, we won't.
I would have never downloaded CSGO if I would have thought it would have led me to look upon furry porn at one point.
I would have.
We actually got some like decent information out of them about like
furries, like, and how they're terrible people.
And like being a young furry, because the kid was in high school and he was like, "Yeah, I'm a furry and I'm working on getting a moose or a moose suit."
I only have the head and paws.
No, he didn't even have the head. He only had the paws.
Oh yeah, he just had the paws. The head's way too expensive for him, bro.
Yeah, bro. And then that other time, we've had a lot, like, of, why have we had so many experiences with furries?
We're just good, I guess.
Are we, like, attractive to furries?
We attract their kind, I think.
Their kind, their people. Yeah.
Well, that other time, you guys played with that guy who was streaming in a full-on
suit. He was a nice guy, but despite the fact that he was a nice guy, I still can't respect him. It's pretty obvious why.
Kind of hard to understand him, too, because
it was kind of like, guys, they're rushing B. It was like that. I definitely didn't just put on my
rushing B.
I wasn't even in that game, but you guys.
He also
were like...
had a guitar.
Really?
Played guitar. Wasn't very good, in my opinion. I don't know what a good guitarist sounds like, but.
Damn.
In my opinion.
No, that's crazy. You guys were in the game, and then you were like, Anthony, you're missing out, bro. This guy's wearing a full-on fursuit. You should go check out his stream. And then I checked out his stream, and it was a video of him playing CS:GO, and I could hear you guys like yelling at each other in the game chat.
Yeah, because that's the only way we can talk to him.
As you do. And then he was just it was like a poorly lit room. And he's sitting there, and it's just like a full-on guy in just a furry costume just on a computer. He's got like this, it's like, it was insane.
I'm a computer. Quit all the downloading. Yeah.
Oh, the things you'll see.
So basically, the moral of the story is do not associate with furries.
You were talking about guitar players before, and you know who's really good at guitar is those people who play it at lunch.
Top 10 best guitarists, what? Number one. Those people who play it in the little nook at lunch.
Little and they elevator said, nook.
They're like, remember they're clapping the whole
oh,
time?
Oh, they're clapping.
Oh,
Patrick, you yelled pretty loud at that.
Yeah, what do you want from me? I'm not going to fucking sit there and listen to
listen
their,
to
like,
claps.
What were they playing, like, fucking, I don't even know, Ed Sheeran? Get the fuck out.
No, it was really bad.
Ed Sheeran.
Somebody used to have, like, an electric guitar, and they played it at lunch one time. Do you remember that?
I remember the guy with the long hair.
Yeah, and he was, like, huge. He was, like, 6 and a half feet
big man.
Tall.
Had the
like
same name
as
you.
Yeah, he did.
He didn't have bad intentions. I talked to him one time.
Pretty sure he's been to jail slash...
He has been to jail since then, so...
I'm pretty sure in the band White Elephant, he was the one who put a pack of condoms in the gift exchange, so...
Oh,
I would
White
not
Elephant
doubt that.
Gift exchange.
Who was it that got him?
It wasn't him, because I know who it was, but...
There was girl that got them, and it was like the worst person.
Oh, who got them? Yeah... She's like, it was like the most innocent person in the whole wide world. And she just opened him up, and then the band teacher goes, guys, that's not funny.
But stop
it,
laughing.
I wasn't
stop
there.
Stop laughing,
I
everyone.
Really
it's
wish
not...
I was there for that. I got Sprite Cranberry at the last one.
You're not welcome.
This year's.
Yeah,
bro. Yeah, it was yours. You tried
I mean,
to steal
basically... it. Basically. I wanted that. I could have left it.
You could have taken thing, it.
Left the same thing. No, I. Anyway.
You could have, but it was against your morals.
If she got it was if If it was a different person that got those, I mean...
You would have taken it?
No, I'm saying if it was a different person, you could have put it to good use.
What? You talking about the condoms?
I'm talking about if someone else were to get that besides someone, like...
I thought we were still talking about the Sprite Cranberry.
No, not me.
Come on, Griffin.
Just saying.
Come on, Griffin.
Come on.
You hate women. Just a minute.
Leave the Discord. No, Eric hates women, bro.
Yeah, Eric hates women. Speaking
yeah,
of
fucking hates
Eric,
women.
Last podcast we talked about Eric being addicted to ketamine. This podcast we could talk about Eric being addicted to hating women.
Hating women, yeah. This morning I sat down because normally we all go to breakfast together on Friday mornings.
Normally.
Normally. But this morning it was just me and Griffin. And so we were at a table set for 8. Just me and Griffin. We each had 2 glasses of water.
The nice little bus lady who's always... I'm not Griffin, but the nice bus lady who always prepares our stuff for us set 8 plates like she always does.
Yeah.
2 people showed up. Kind of sad, though.
It was pretty sad. And then so we got to school super early. And Eric gets to school super early because he gets a ride with somebody who has to be
there
early.
He's there like
6:50. Yeah, he's there very early. And I go up there and he's like kind of taking a nap. And I kick him around and I'm like, Eric, you hate women. And then he goes,
So basically, Eric hates women confirmed.
And then there's a girl I know behind him. And I'm like, do you hear that? Eric hates women. And she goes, yeah, it's okay. We hate Eric too. Is
well,
Eric
a girl?
I've seen Eric actually hit a woman, and I did nothing about it. But I mean,
is that true?
It's 100% factual. On the death of my dog.
Palm.
Palm.
Chickasheen happens to be muted right now.
I'm chewing something.
Are you? What are you eating, bud?
He eats high chews a lot, and he even though I gave him like 20, he's not giving me a single one.
Because I said you could come over and get some, and you said
I'm not gonna drive to your house to grab high chews.
Austin,
what are high chews?
Austin, I first. No, okay.
Who asked what high chews are?
High chews are. High chews are a candy made. I know the lore on this.
The lore?
So
yes, there is.
High chews were made. Because in Japan, it was rude to
spout your gum in the trash. Of Mount Doom.
Anyway, in Japan, it was rude to spit out your gum into the trash. And stop, please. And people still wanted to chew gum. So this guy, he decided to make a candy like Haichu, which is very chewy like gum. But eventually it dissolves and you can swallow it. So you can avoid the whole spitting out process.
It's very good flavored, also.
It's
really?
Very good. And anyway, so Austin, I drove to your house and ate them at your house when I drove there. Therefore, why would you not drive to my house to get them?
First of all, you never let us inside your house. I don't even know what the inside of your house looks like.
You've been inside my house before.
You guys have been friends for, like, ever.
Since birth? I
Austin,
know.
You've been
and
in
I
my
do
house
not know
before.
What the inside of his house looks like.
No, you've been in there before.
Maybe, like, in the front... Like, I stood in the doorway, maybe?
Through my back door into the living room? You've been there before, in my room?
When? Like, 5th grade? I don't remember that.
I remember it.
Okay, well.
Because my house is... There's nothing good to, like, hosting in my house. It's just...
Griffin, I was trying to get, like, a heated blanket, which I will
know, I was there.
You blocked the doorway.
Because it was dirty.
And would not let me pass.
Because it's dirty in there.
I just wanted to walk like one step indoors.
Griffin,
like...
my room's always dirty, bro.
Yeah, but you have no standards.
What'd you say?
He said you have no standards is what he said. Jesus.
Oh my god.
You just kept putting time out, Clark.
By the way,
yeah,
that was bad. Okay, but seriously, it was dirty in there. Worse than your room, Austin, and I didn't want Patrick to see it.
My room's not actually that dirty all the time.
Yo, if Patrick will let you go in pee corner, and you won't even let him go in your house.
Yeah,
bro.
For real. Patrick
can
is not
explain the lore for
of
this?
A pee corner.
No, you probably should. We probably should explain
please.
The lore for pee
first
corner.
Off,
people are going to think I pee in my corner in my bedroom.
No, it's not in the bedroom. It's in the basement. Basement, there's a corner where you
yeah,
can't.
Yeah, I pee in that corner. But no one can right. see it, so it's
okay. Fine. The lore is one time, long before the reunion between Patrick and Anthony, Me, Patrick, Griffin, and Eric were playing hide and seek in Patrick's basement. And there's this one corner right to the right when you walk in that smells so horrendously of cat pee that you can't even go near it without, like, gagging. And ever since, it's just been deemed pee corner. It's legendary around the school. You'd have to. No one knows the extent of how bad it smells, though. So.
Okay, I went down there, and my parents must have cleaned it a little bit because it did not smell nearly as bad.
I won't believe it till I see it.
Did it still smell a little bad, at least?
Oh, I, like, licked the floor and stuff, and it's not nearly as bad as it was. So.
I hope the snow keeps...
Not until so I pee in there again.
So we can go to your house and, like, fucking...
No, he can't go to his house tomorrow because he's playing D&D with your siblings. Shut up!
Who plays D&D with their siblings, bro?
Okay, aside from that, I am also... My nephews are at my house.
I do not care about your nephews. Words cannot describe how much I don't care about your nephews, okay? I'll beat the shit out of them. I will not hesitate.
Griffin, can you justify why you keep muting your mic and then putting random pictures in the Discord?
Okay, well, for starters, I only put one picture. Austin put two. And I mute my mic because...
Yeah, please.
Okay, yep, it's called dedication to the podcast, not to chew while you're on it, you know?
I agree with Patrick.
I would too. I definitely agree. What, like, there's a picture of, it's like Bart and that guy with all the Cheetos in his mouth.
They're not Cheetos, they're tater tots.
That's Austin's picture.
Those are not tater tots.
Yes, they are. Corn dogs.
They're not tater tots, I'll tell you that. Look at how long, like, if you look at the picture, they're one that's, like, super long.
Tater tots can be long.
I think it's Photoshop, that's why it's warped a little bit.
Yeah, it's definitely tater tots, I know for a fact.
And then it's that one picture of Goofy who is like, oh. and then there's
Biggie Cheese.
You mean every picture of Goofy. That's every picture.
No, well he
those
is...
are the you noises just... Goofy makes.
That is true.
To describe, like, the picture.
But he's like, his teeth are all like, okay, I can't. They're all this.
So
Yo, you had to have been there, bro.
You had to be there, bro.
It's Goofy, but he's looking skeptical as fuck. Or high, depending on internet.
In the bottom right corner, it says,
I was just going to say,
quickmeme.com.
Very cool. You get that off quickmeme.com?
If I'm being honest.
Just drop my phone.
This picture of Biggie Cheese looks cursed. Like, look at his eyes.
That's just Biggie, bro.
Yeah, his pupils are so wide.
No, they're not. Those are his glasses, bro.
Those are glasses.
Inside his eyelids?
God, those don't look like... Those look like eyes.
Those are his glasses. Boy, those are like little tiny rapper glasses.
Oh, wait. Are you
bro.
Talking about...
It looks better
yeah,
now.
Yeah, those are glasses.
Okay, it looked like his eyes.
I thought you were talking about... Really bad. Goofy
Carl,
and Big
Carl Weezer.
Top 5 hottest woman in video games, number 1, Carl Weezer.
Biggie Cheese looks like he has like a Glasgow smile. Like, fuck.
What does Glasgow smile mean?
Yeah.
That's what the Joker has.
Oh.
Oh. Nah.
Someone cuts your
Where you
face,
cut it?
Like
cut it.
Yeah.
Why the fuck do you
I think
that?
I might react to this.
That's why I'm gonna be good at trivia.
That's true. I'm excited for trivia night. That'll
I'm also excited.
We should make the name Angry Birds and only answer Angry Birds.
Every single question.
No, I think we could actually win the high school category this year.
Yeah, I think
last year our team wasn't very stacked, but I feel this year it could be.
Who was on your team last year?
I don't want to say.
Okay.
It was the girlfriend.
It was us and our girlfriends.
And Austin's girl.
And then. Some
Concrete Babby said not good.
Please don't do that.
What's
that's very, very loud.
What does the name of the other person
that's
start?
That's incredibly loud.
For me, it's just normal.
Anyways. It was me, us and our girlfriends and then their friends. It was just bad.
Brutal. We were brutally murdered.
Yeah. Like,
okay, the
like us and our girlfriends would have answers, but then the rest of them were just
two.
Like... We did win best decorated table though.
Which
what did we win? Like $15?
$25
All right, we each got $5. Which is kind of unfair. We probably should have gave more money to people who bought
decorations. No, we gave more money to my girlfriend because she bought decorations.
Oh. I suppose.
Dude, okay.
Bought the bowling pins.
To be fair, I think Eric is going to do the same shit where he doesn't say anything.
And no, Eric...
Eric's
kind of
good at trivia.
Eric's pretty good with trivia.
Is this like a table group thing? The answer is one, or you each people get different answers?
The answer is one.
Questions.
Yeah.
All right, got it.
So you sit around a table, and it's like it's in the gym, and there's like over 100 tables, and there's teams of eight, and they ask the question over like a big speaker.
It's a very well attended event.
I can only think of five, maybe six people on the team, but who would be added to that?
I mean, it doesn't have
to
be
the Brazilian.
You can say his name. He's been in a video.
Oh, Leo.
That's why I said five or six.
But not everyone watching these videos is like a murderer, you know?
Yeah, why are you so like...
Ever since the furry incident, I can't trust anybody.
You can't even tell my first name.
You told them my address.
No, you told them your address.
Yeah,
I didn't say anything
you
about
tell
your,
the
address.
Your address.
Everybody, that was probably partially me.
Oh, yeah, you started it and Patrick finished it.
Yeah, Patrick did tell the furries his full address. Cause he's
not
like,
the full
what are they going to do? They're going to come get me?
I'm still waiting for them to show up. Got my mer suit ready.
I'm ready for that mer pile.
Joke's on them. I was trying to murder them all along.
Murder them.
Murder.
Jesus, what was that?
Oh, dude, that's all.
The fact that his mic keeps cutting out makes it even better, bro.
It's because it's push to talk. I'm doing it.
Yeah.
Hey, can you guys hear me again?
Yeah, before we set up this podcast, we took probably at least 20 minutes to try to
figure
out
me?
Patrick's mic. Yes, we can hear you.
Okay, I accidentally did something.
What'd you do?
Then I get,
nothing.
I'm trying to give it up. Yeah,
what? He's doing it on purpose.
He's doing it for attention, bro.
Yeah, doing it for attention.
Hey,
bro.
That's something else we can talk about. Patrick's attention problem.
Yeah. It's great because even people besides us recognize it. Like, coach recognized it.
Yeah, our swim coach recognized it.
Yeah.
Not well.
You guys are.
Hey,
fucking...
Patrick. You know what hasn't changed since freshman year? Your constant need for attention. How did that make you feel, Patrick? Oh fuck! I just knocked over my pod racer.
I'm trying to articulate my feelings here, and let me tell you, it was subtle at first, but the embarrassment of the entire swim team knowing of my whorishness with attention slowly spread, and in this essay, I will analyze my emotions during the moment.
Wonderful.
And then I actually ordered like an entire fucking essay of me getting roasted by my swim coach.
Do it, bro.
Wait a minute, which one is the North Korean flag?
The one with the swastika on it.
Yeah. Did you guys in English today?
Oh, yes. That is not the North
Mr.
Korean
Pickle?
Flag.
The article
Mr.
in...
Mr. Pickle.
Well, yeah, Mr. Pickle. And they were dueling, but they were like, no after you, sir. After you. No, sir. Let me help you take your...
That's not true.
Yes, it was. Before the duel, they were like, may I take your boots, sir?
Okay, they were.
But during the duel, Godfrey was like, aha, Jeb. And then he hit Pickle's arm, and then Pickle's like, attack brush. Da-da-da-da-da-da. And in his fury,
he got his sword
broke. Pickle's sword broke.
Pickle's... Yeah, Godfrey caught Pickle's sword.
And then Godfrey was like, maybe don't stake your life on such a shitty sword, see?
Okay, can I say what happened?
Yeah, go for it, bro.
The guy, according to Bruce, apparently I just, you know, totally misinterpreted the whole thing. But according to Bruce, they dueled, and the sword broke, and the guy was like, huh,
This sword is inferior. I do not like you, innkeep. And then walked away.
That is not what happened. I don't think that's at all.
That's what Bruce said happened.
Yeah, Bruce was also done in 10 minutes, so.
Yeah, fair.
Speaking of Bruce, ranted about you hard, Patrick, on the way home.
Really?
Yeah, it's because I literally talked shit about him to his face, so that's fair.
What did Bruce rant about?
He went a lot about this part where Patrick told Bruce, "Are you taking a piss?" And then Bruce got mad, and he was telling me all the facts telling me all the facts about how that's not a true saying. And he looked it up. He's like, "See right here, there's nothing that says taking a piss is real."
What is that?
What do you mean real?
I explain what happened?
Yes.
So we were trying to do funny accents, right, at the AP stats table. I leaned over to Eric and I was like, "Okay, Eric, are you having a piss?" And Eric, laughed and understood that it was just like a funny gag or whatever, haha, funny. And Bruce looked at me with indignation and told me that it was like fucking, it's taking the piss. It's actually taking the piss. That's what they say. And then I was like, yeah, okay, Bruce. Like, I didn't really care, but he had this, like, vendetta against it. And he ranted in private with, like, Griffin. I don't understand.
Yeah, he did.
Damn, bro.
He got the whole squad.
Also that. He keeps saying that exact phrase over and over.
There's that picture I posted on Twitter of, damn, bro, you got the whole squad left. the one that's of us.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's a good
picture. Keep saying, haha, poopy funny, too late, like way after we all said it, and then says pog all the time.
He says pog? In real life, bro?
He's like, that's pretty pog.
Yo, pog champ, bro, pog champ.
Pog champ, bro. But it's pog now, poggers. Actually. Pog is a different one from pog champ.
Poggers.
What is he says that, I don't like it.
They're just Twitch emoticons.
I know, but what's the difference?
Pog is like up close on the mouth, and that's it. Did you guys see the picture I took this morning? Of Eric?
What? I did.
Oh, yes, I saved it. It's such a good picture, bro.
What was the caption I put on it? I don't even remember.
I can't
something about hating women.
The usual, I hate women.
Oh, no, the caption was when you catch your buddies talking about premarital sex.
Oh, yeah.
No.
Bro, it's freaking gross.
Yeah. And on that note...
It was the picture you took this morning, Eric, in the library.
Yeah, I'll see you next week.
We'll see you next week, guys.
This has been a great time. Goodbye.
I've had a good time. Bye.